Your Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., President of the Republic of the Philippines, First Lady Mrs. Luis Araneta Marcos, Honorable Secretaries of the Cabinet, Senators and Members of Congress, Members of the Judiciary, other distinguished government officials and military officers, Your Excellencies, the ambassadors accredited to the Republic of the Philippines, other diplomats and heads of mission of international organizations. It is my honor and privilege this morning as the Dean of the Diplomatic Corps to express to Your Excellency, Mr. President, the collective and sincere best wishes of the entire Diplomatic Corps on the 126th anniversary of the proclamation of the independence of the Republic of the Philippines, which took place on this day in the town that was then called Cavite Viejo. And then 64 years after that moment, it was also on this day, in June of 1962, that President Diosdado Macapagal proposed that the independence of the Republic of the Philippines would be celebrated on June 12th, because, in his words, and I quote, "It is proper that what we should celebrate is not the day when other nations gave recognition to our independence, but the day when we declared our desire to exercise our inherent and inalienable right to freedom and independence," close quote. And thus, June 12th became the Independence Day of the Philippines, ratified 2 years later by an act of Congress. In his speech on June 12, 1962, President Macapagal spoke of the Filipinos as a people molded into a nation by a process of cultural evolution and a sense of oneness born of common struggle and suffering. That theme of oneness, or to use the Latin-based synonym, unity, has been central to the presidency of Your Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., and it is a noble and honorable aspiration. The achievement of unity arising from and coexisting with legitimate diversity is surely the goal of a truly democratic society, a unity in diversity that is sustained through political engagement involving various parties. In this connection, the international community supports and indeed congratulates the Philippines for the impressive progress that has been made in these years through the Bangsamoro peace process. In this, the 10th anniversary of the signing of the comprehensive agreement on Bangsamoro. Your Excellency, if you would permit me a personal observation. In February of this year, I had the privilege of visiting Jolo, a place that, as all of us know, suffered grievously during the long years of armed conflict. In my encounters there with civic and religious leaders, as well as with ordinary citizens, I can only say that I was overwhelmed by the sense of hope that is present now in the hearts of the people in Jolo. And so, Mr. President, at this moment, with the date of the first BARM parliamentary elections less than 1 year away, let me reiterate the support of the Diplomatic Corps for this process. Let us all do everything we possibly can to ensure that the hopes of the people of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region and Muslim Mindanao will not be disappointed. When President Macapagal gave his speech in June of 1962 proposing the change of the date of the Independence Day of the Philippines, the world was experiencing dangerous polarization, which indeed came to a crisis point only a few months later in October of that year. Regrettably, our geopolitical situation in 2024 is not so different. The end of history did not arrive in the 1990s. History has continued. polarization and violent conflicts resulting from it are a reality at this moment. In this situation, if we want to make a world of safety and prosperity for our children, the way forward for all of us is the same path that has brought the hope of peace to the people of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region and Muslim Mindanao. And that is the path of dialogue, patient, serious dialogue, together with a respect for international law and a respect for legitimate diversity. Engaging with others, and particularly those with whom we profoundly disagree, is the surest way of avoiding the catastrophe of escalation. Your Excellency, Mr. President, I know that I speak for the entire diplomatic corps when I say that it is a pleasure for us to serve here in the Philippines, this nation of legendary friendliness and hospitality. And allow me to make a small shout out for the Department of Foreign Affairs, with whom we, the ambassadors, interact with on almost a daily basis. It's always a pleasure to interact with them. And for all these reasons, it's an honor for me to express, on behalf of the Diplomatic Corps, our heartfelt congratulations and best wishes on this anniversary of the proclamation of the independence of your nation. And now, dear friends, if we could have a glass. Dear friends, allow me to conclude my remarks by asking you to join me in a toast. To the President of the Republic of the Philippines, His Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., for his well-being, health, and success, and for the peace, prosperity, and happiness of the Filipino people, may God bless the Philippines. Mabuhay. Mabuhay. Cheers.
Thank you very much. For all of your attendance, Your Excellencies, at this Bananar. And I thank, of course, the Dean of the Diplomatic Corps and Apostolic Nuncio to the Philippines, the Most Reverend Archbishop Charles John Brown, for his very kind remarks, and which reflects a very good understanding, I think, of the Filipino culture. And we are very flattered and are happy to call you and the rest of the members of the Diplomatic Corps as friends. I was noticing when we were welcoming the different ambassadors how much conversation we all had with each other. And this is an indication of all the many things that we have started in the past year or so, and the things that we are following up. There are so many things that we still talk about. And for that assistance, the comments of our the Apostolic Nuncio about BARM, again, we look to many of our friends and allies for all the assistances they have given us. If we have met with any kind of success, that success, your assistance has been an enormous part of that success. And for that, we thank you, and for the engagements that we have made in the past year or so, I thank you for that too, and we look forward to continuing that. Allow me to also greet the Senate President Chiza Escudero. Also here with us is the House Speaker Martin Romualdez, all the other excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Executive Secretary Chief Luke Bersamin, and of course someone who you are actually more familiar with and spend more time with than myself, the First Lady. First Lady Lisa Araneta Marcos. All my fellow workers in government, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is a great pleasure for me to host this very important occasion with the members of the Diplomatic Corps. We celebrate the proudest moment of our storied past, the Philippine independence. 126 years on, since the Philippine flag was first unfurled in 1898 to let flutter in the fresh breeze of freedom, the flame of Filipino nationalism that sustained our ancestors in their quest for freedom remains lit in the beating heart of the Filipino nation to this very day. The glow is not lost to us. From a flickering flame into a fiery blaze, this is how our patriotic sentiments can easily rouse whenever our collective and common interest as a nation is tested. On many occasions, great trials have all the more strengthened our resolve and unified our people. Because as I have said, Filipinos do not yield. The struggle for Philippine independence continues to reverberate to this day, not against colonial oppression, but against modern-day challenges. We draw inspiration from the valor, resilience, and untiring spirit of our forefathers as we tackle these new challenges confronting our country. Today's reception is more than just a commemoration of the birth of the Philippine Republic, the first in Asia, but a strong affirmation of our century-old nationhood and of our collective duty as Filipinos to safeguard what our forefathers have fought and died for so that we may carry on our sacrosanct mandate to protect our country and to defend everything that is rightly ours from those who will try to cross these lines. We must dig deep into our valiant past, draw strength from the heroism of our forefathers, and let this heritage of selflessness propel us forward into the future. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, as I steer the economic rudder of the nation towards progress, I'm guided by the newly minted brand of governance that we have come to call Bagong Pilipinas, which roughly translates into New Philippines. It is a brand of governance that engenders social and economic inclusivity and transformation, inspires hope and confidence in our people, and promises transformative change for the betterment of Filipinos. To bring this aspiration to fruition, my administration continues to institute policies and implement measures as laid out in our plans aimed at galvanizing the economy amidst global economic difficulties. The recent launching of Bagong Pilipinas is opportune to chart a new beginning for the Philippines that transcends political color and social background. Allow me to take this occasion to share with you the state of our economy. Despite the woes brought about by global inflation, our country has still managed to curb inflation to a reasonable, almost manageable level. It remains, unfortunately, our greatest problem. And this is inflation that is brought about by forces that we cannot control. But nonetheless, I think that we have done a good job. And with this, it is a very large improvement from what we were under, the situation that we were under maybe a year ago. To date, we are within 3.5%. We're within the government's target band of 2 to 4. I also happy to note that the Philippines continues to enjoy a good rating as an investment, and a credit rating as an investment destination. We are credited with a stable outlook, which signals growth in the momentum in the medium term. It translates to more accessible financing for our government and for our programs. So we will maintain that status, and we will try to improve that and across all major regional and international agencies. We now continue to work on our growth, and we have now recently been forecast to have one of the highest growth rates for the next year. And I think that this bodes well for the transformation of our economy, especially as we are trying to recover from the effects of our very bad drought and the trying to prepare for what is coming with the rainy season. So we continue to, but we on the foreign policy front, And I was just listening to the Apostolic Nuncio, and I said, you have made a very, very good description of foreign policy. I should write it down. And with your permission, I will plagiarize some of your description. We continue to chart an independent foreign policy in keeping with our constitutional mandate. We pursue through international engagements that seek to strengthen existing alliances, build new partnerships with like-minded states. Our foreign policy is grounded on the continuing promotion and work for peace, and the continuing promotion and work for our national interest. On the global stage, we have taken positions in support of the rule of law and of the rules-based international order, grounded on the principles laid out in the UN Charter and multilateral conventions. As we continue to promote diplomacy and dialogue in our efforts to build bridges in our various multilateral advocacies, such as for peace, economic development, climate change, and amongst others, we shall endeavor to enhance engagements with bilateral, regional, multilateral partners, especially in areas where cooperation has not yet reached its full potential. With Bagong Pilipinas, it is with confidence that I say that we are engaging the world for our country and for our people. At this point, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to ask you to join me in a toast and raise a glass to stronger bilateral ties between our countries and deepening linkages between our peoples in the many years ahead. Here's to all of your good health, long life, and prosperity. Cheers.